Right, my guests are Love and Rockets, which A is, I think, a brilliant name for a band, and B, you may recognise one through the faces if you're a Bauhaus fans, and if you're even more into music, you may remember a band called Turns on Tails, of which these two guys were part of. This is Danny Ash, and that's David Jay, and this is Kevin Haskins over there. Great sound effects, yeah.
Be careful.
You're welcome. Anyway, this is Sky. Thanks for coming in. Where you come from today?
From Northampton.
Is that where...
planet's about 70 miles.
Mm. Yeah, it's not that far away, is it? Is that where you're all based, then?
Yeah.
Okay, well, thanks for shooting down the motorway. So tell me about Love and Rockets. As yet, I've not heard or seen anything of you until we see the video in a short while. So I remember Bauhaus well, and love Bauhaus, of which all three of you are part. Any regrets in splitting it up? Whose idea was it to split up Bauhaus?
It was a collective decision,
right.
And it was the right time, so there's no regrets there.
No. And you built up a good following. Will they follow you? Did they follow you through, to you in particular, with Turns on Tails or not?
To a degree. I mean, we did one tour in England, which lasted about a three-week tour, and went over to America for about the same amount of time. And there were a certain amount of the people that carried on. You know, there were obviously a lot of people in the audience that like Bauhaus, but that didn't really work out as well as it should have. So, myself and Kevin preferred to work with David anyway, so we decided to get back together again.
It's not that easy to wreck what was a really good band and start something afresh. It's a bit of a nerve-wracking experience, and you've now done it for the third time. What's going to be so special about Love and Rockets?
It's hard to put into words, really.
I mean, the band, obviously, I mean, with your credibility and the respect you've already gained, I mean, you, musically, I don't know what direction you're intending to go in. Is there going to be a bit of Bauhaus there or not?
Well, I think that's bound to be there slightly.
An element of it.
An element of it, but this is a new concept, if you like.
Bringing you into 85, as such.
Yeah, it's more hard-edged, I think.
Okay, so Love and Rockets has been a plan for how long, then?
Since Christmas.
Oh, so it's a fairly new baby, as such, then.
But we always said that we'd work together again anyway, particularly us three. I mean, it's just like a chemistry that we had musically that always seems to work. And we just went to a rehearsal just after Christmas. And the first rehearsal, we just thought we'd try Wall of Confusion. It's something that we wanted to do for a cover. Well, it was Kevin's idea. And it seemed to work straight away, you know, within the first sort of 20 minutes, half hour, it seemed to come together immediately, although we hadn't worked with each other for about 18 months or so. So we knew we had it, you know.
It's never easy to take such a classic as Ball of Confusion and turn it into something a bit personal, a bit special.
I think it's a timely cover.
So do I.
Yeah, it's very pertinent now to the times, now as it was when it was released, 10 years ago?
Right, we're going to see that now. And we'll talk about how it looks and how it sounds directly on this. So this is Love and Rockets, Ball of Confusion.
People moving in, why? Because of the color of the skin. Run, 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 but you just can't hide. An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. Vote for me and I'll set you free. Person talking about love today is the preacher, and he sings, nobody gets you started learning, but the teacher. Segregation, termination, demonstration, integration, aggravation, mediation, devastation of the nation. Ball of confusion, that's what the world is today. Hey, hey. Ball of confusion, that's what the world is today. Hey, hey. In the summertime, and the beat goes on, and the beat goes on, and the beat goes on, and the beat goes on. Economics, Reaganomics, birth control, the sound of soul,
shooting rockets to the moon. Kids going up to soon, the politicians say. And the band plays on. So round and around and around we go. Where the world's heading, nobody knows. Full of confusion, that's what the world is today. Hey, hey. Full of confusion, that's what the world is today. Hey, hey. Hey, hey. Fear in the air, tension everywhere. Unemployment rising fast. And the band played on, and the band played on, and the band played on, and the band played Eve of Destruction, tax deductions, inspectors of collection, solid gold in demand, population out of hand, suicide, too many bills, everyone moving to the hills,
people all over the world
are dying in the war. And the band played on, and the band played on, and the band played on. And the band played for the confusion. That's what the world is today. Hey, hey. Hey, for the confusion. That's what the world is today. Hey, hey. For the confusion.
For the confusion.
That's what the world is today. Hey, hey. Hey, for the confusion.
For the confusion.
That's what the world is today.
That is really powerful. You're quite pleased though, aren't you? I should imagine. Kevin, thank you for that sound effects there. How did you get the song into that sort of, get that song to the feel you managed to achieve? Do you have to strip it to its bare roots again or what?
Yeah, that's probably something that has been carried through from Bauhaus, where we always had that in mind to keep things as simple as possible, but to the maximum effect. And
It's worked brilliantly.
That's how we approached that particular song.
Now, the song also has been released, if I'm right, for another reason, because it's part of a film. Is that correct?
Yeah, it's going to be. I mean, that wasn't part of the reason for recording it or releasing it initially,
right.
but it's been picked up on.
So someone heard it and said, I want to use it.
Yeah, by an American company.
Yeah.
And they seem to think that it fits in with their movie, so they're going to use it.
What kind of movie is it going to work to?
Apparently, well, it's set in New York, like a million other films, and it's something to do with somebody's obsession with somebody else, and that's about as much as we know, really. And it's going to be used in conjunction with a fairground scene, so it all sounds very interesting.
But you kept that hard edge there, which I think is really successful. I mean, it's still reminiscent of Bauhaus there, at the same time as I feel, as a Bauhaus fan anyway.
Yeah. I think...
obviously you're not ashamed of what's gone before. And you're
I think this is very relevant for 1985, as we were talking about before, whereas Bauhaus was sort of relevant for 1982 or whatever. And it's just a sort of progression, really.
It's an extension of what we were doing.
Yeah.
It's a lot more... What we're doing now is a lot more open-ended, really. Mm. Because Bauhaus was... it was almost like a fixed idea, and only certain things worked within that framework, but this is much more open.
I think the problem is you're going to get people like me forever asking you about the past and relating the new band to Bauhaus and all that scene, and after a bit you're going to get so absolutely up to here with it.
Depends.
You're going to turn around and say, but that can only take over, Love and Rockets can only take over when it's had success, yes?
Yeah.
Yes. Right, yeah.
So I mean, you've got to actually achieve that success first.
Yeah.
So how are you going to go about it? You've got a first single out, which is a strong track.
Well, I mean, we're hoping this is going to do something. We're hoping this is going to do a lot, actually. I mean, we're hoping to chart with this in England. I don't know if that's going to happen, but that's the idea.
Is there an album in the?
Yes, I mean,
we're recording all the time. Yeah. We've got another single recorded, so we're just working at it all the time.
Not only that, but also the visual aspect of the band is really good too. I mean, on that video again, it shows that you've been around for a bit, because you can actually put the song across really well. Some bands tend to die as soon as you put a camera in front of them, but you guys seem to be very strident in your attitude visually.
Mm.
I mean, is it with the film, for instance? I mean, is there any chance at all of you continuing? Would you like to do a video album or anything like that? Or is it purely music?
Never contemplated a video album.
I mean, that is what it is. I mean, UB40, for instance, have managed very successfully to do a very clever black and white video album as such, which seemed to get across to a lot of people what they felt about.
It's a difficult thing, I think, the whole field, because you're in danger of putting too much of a fixed interpretation on a piece of music and thereby taking away the listener's own imaginative interpretation, you know what I mean? So it's difficult to make it ambiguous and at the same time positive.
You were very big in Europe, weren't you, Bauhaus? You had quite a large following.
Yeah, it still seems to, it's amazing because it still seems to have, it's kept that resonance going there. I was over there
that nice hard
a few
edge.
Months ago and there's still an interest in Bauhaus. Mm.
Well, I wish you a lot of luck with Love and Rockets.
Thank you.
I really think it's a good idea. What has ever happened to Peter Murphy, by the way?
We was working with Mick Kahn, but I'm not sure if that's still carrying on. As far as we know, actually, he's just writing songs. Mm. And I think he's in the studio next week, in actual fact. He's working with somebody at 4AD.
Well, you're ahead of him at the moment, anyway. So I wish you luck with that. Whatever, not that there's a battle there at all.
No,
but,
not at all. I mean, we're still
not the slightest.
With friends with him.
Yeah. Well, good luck with the Mickey Rourke film. The film which it's part of is called 9 1/2 Weeks.
Yeah.
When's that going to come out?
I think that's out in July in America.
Yeah.
I think that's the actual date for it to come out. It's actually been filmed. I mean, they're just sorting out the rushes at the moment. And, we were just approached.
Mm. Well, good luck with that.
Because that particular track fits in with it.
I'll say it does. Ball of Confusion. Right, we should be playing that quite a lot, hopefully, if all goes well. And that was Love and Rockets. Danny Ash, David Jay, and Kevin Haskins. Thanks, all three. Thanks for coming down from Northampton. Right. Cracking on, Country Boy. This is a guy called Ricky Skaggs. Yeah, Ricky Skaggs and Country Boy, and a taste of what's to come with the Boot Hill Foot Tappers, my guest in a short while, and playing live here as well. I felt really a bit despondent. I didn't have a chance to talk to Love and Rockets in more depth, but it's very difficult when a band just starts off and they've only been going since Christmas and their first single's released, and especially when you've got memories like I have of the band Bauhaus. One tends to want to relay everything to Bauhaus, which is absolutely wrong, because when a band forms, all it wants to do is be taken for what it is now and given the boost and the chance. And they've got it, because what a great, great track. What a good video. Ball of Confusion. I look forward to playing that one again. Love and Rockets are the band. And look out for more from them.